Good morning all. So this is Chandrasekhar Pri, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, ATMA College of Engineering. So today I'm going to give an explanation on the program bit stuffing and character stuffing from a computer networks lab. So today we'll discuss how the bit stuffing and how to write a program for a bit stuffing and a character stuffing. So before starting with the program, I need some information regarding to how the bit stuffing is going to be work. So bit stuffing is also called as a bit oriented protocol. So to this protocol I'm going to write a program for this. So bit oriented protocol. So bit oriented protocol is a data section of a frame, is a sequence of bits to interpret by the upper layer of any format of a multimedia system. However, in addition to this, we'll have a header as well as we'll have a tailor. So these are needed to delimit, or these are used as a delimiter to separate the one frame from another frame. So most of the protocol, what we are going to use a special 8-bit pattern, which are called as a flags. So here we are going to consider a flag as a 0111110, which is of an 8-bit pattern, has a delimiter to define the beginning and the ending of the frame. So next question, what is that bit stuffing is? So bit stuffing is a process of adding one extra zeros. When we need to add in these extra zeros, whenever I find five consecutive ones in my sequence of data. So in my sequence of data, if I found any five ones, consecutive ones, then I'm going to follow with an zero in the data. So why we need to add in zero? Next question. Because just to see that at the receiver, whatever I'm going to be transmitted, it has to received at the receiving side. So at the receiver, it doesn't make any mistakes in the pattern of a 0111110 for a flag. So that's why we are going to add a zero for a consecutive number of ones. So we'll take an example of this. So this is the data 0000111110111110100. Now you will have a doubt, from where I got this data? So this data is nothing but what we have been received to the data link layer. So this bit stuffing and the character stuffings will be done at the data link layer only. So to get in data to the data link layer, I need from where this data layer got a data. So this data will be received from a network layer. So the datas what will be there in a network layer will be in the form of packets, and those packets are converted to the frames in a data link layer. So that's why we say that the data from the upper layer. So data from the upper layer means nothing but the data what you have got in a network layer, that will be transmitted to the data link layer. So in a data link layer, now the stuffing has to be done before transmitting any frame. So how this stuffing? So before going to see the stuffing things, we'll understand while transmitting any frames from a source to the destination, what will the pattern of the frame is. The pattern of the frame is so simple and quite easier. That is the first bit, the field one, what we call as a flag, and the second field what we call as a header, and the third field what we call as a data, and the fourth field what we call as a tailor, and the fifth field what we call as again a flag. So those flags are used to differentiate between one frame to another frame. And next comes with a header. In this header we'll have information of source address and the destination address, that is from where the data has to be transmitted to, from where to where. It's just like a post office protocol. That's it. And next comes with a tailor bit. So this is the special bit what it has been incorporated in a data link layer, because this each and every layer will have a headers files, that is it will have a contents of information of source and destination. But this tailor bit is a special thing what is going to be added during the frame sent by the data link layer. Why this tailor bit is added in a data link layer, why not in others? Next is the tailor bit what we had, it is used to check the errors that has been occurred. It is used to check an error. So this what we call as a checksum bit. So what is the use of check and bait? It is only to detect an error. So hence the main operations of a data link layer, that is responsible of a data link layer, is one is a framing and one is a flow control, one is an error control. So these are the three most responsible things the data link layer is going to be take care of it. Next, once we know about this, next we'll come to a data field. So this data field is nothing but the data what is received from an upper layer. So in this data, I am going to see, or I am going to do the stuffing operation. That means adding in zeros whenever I found consecutive number of ones, five consecutive number of ones in my data. So you can see here. So when I consider this data, so when in an original, in my original, what is the data received from a network layer has gotten from this point to this point, have gotten a series of ones. So how many number of ones we have? We have around an seven number of ones. But the stuffing is, what the stuffing says, whenever I find a consecutive ones, five consecutive ones in my data, I need to add zero to avoid the mistakes at the receiver side. So by doing this here to this data, I have added in two extra bits, which is called as an if bit stuffing, and this will be transmitted to the physical layer, and in turn from a physical layer it will again received at a destination side, and at the destination side again it first data will be received at a physical, then it leaves to the, and then goes to then a data link layer. So in this data link layer, whatever the zeros what we added during before transmitting any data, that zero has to be removed. The removing of those zeros what we call as an unstuffing. So it is called as an bit unstuffing. Why it is bit stuffing? Because here we are going to talk in terms of an zeros and ones. So bit means a binary digits. Binary digits are zeros and ones. Hence we process, we be called as an bit stuffing and an bits unstuffing. So next we'll see how to write a program. So before going to write any program, first I need to understand how to do the stuffing operation. So whatever the data have been received from an upper layer. So to that have done some simple exercises, that is by writing an algorithm. So this algorithm gives a process how the code is been written. So here we are going to consider a read of a sequence of data from the users, that is the users is going to enter the data sequence. So once the data sequence has been entered from the users, so it has to be count how many number of lengths we have been entered. So this second thing is what we need to measure the length of the enter sequence. Once the length of the enter sequence is counted, next thing is I need to check each and every bit, whether it's a 0 or a 1. So if the number of ones, because means here the stuffing is done only for a number of ones that has been occurred. So I am going to count only a ones, how many number of ones that has been counted. So to check each bit and count for a consecutive number of ones in a bit pattern, we use a counter. So in this counter, if the number of ones is exactly equal to the 5, then we will attach a bit called as a 0 immediately after an current position of an. So till once the counter reaches n 5, that indicates that there is a number of ones is n 5, so it will add n zeros. So once it has been done, again the counter has to be checked for an next bit whether it's n zeros and ones. So to do that, again the counter has to get restarted. So this will be go up to these steps will repeat till the completion of n sequence what the users has been entered. So after sequence has been finished, then I need to add a flag bit of an 8 pattern bit of a 0, 111, 111, 0 at the source and the destination. So once it has been done, the entire thing what the data is called as a frame that is going to be received. So now we look over how this program is done. First thing, we need to include two libraries which are the most in a bit stuffing and an a character stuffing. So which is that? One is a string.h. So what is this? What is the use of including this string.h? So this string.h will have an information. This library or header files have a defined keywords or the operation that has to be performed. So I am going to use an a characters oriented. Hence, I'm going to use a sequence of a strings that is going to be performed. For an example, length of the string, concatenation of the string, comparison of the string. So all these functions or keywords, what I'm going to be used, that will be incorporated, or that will be the functionality will be there in an string.h. And next comes with a header, which is called, that is the header file, which is called as a standard input and output. So what is the use of using this standard input and output? So this standard input and output header will have the information of an whatever the keywords we are going to use, printf and then scanf. So what is the use of this printf and scanf? Printf is a nothing but it display whatever we have been included in the program that has to be displayed for an user to be give the information that is on the monitor. And once the display has been monitored, I am going to enter any data from a keyboard, that those data has to be received to the processor or a CPU. That means the data has to be scanned, so that data, the scanning process will be taken care by the scanf statement. So here in a scanf statement, if you give percentage H, it's related to the string. If you give percentage C, it's related to the character. If you give percentage D, it is related to the decimal. If you give percentage O, it's related to the octa numbers. Like that, we have gotten different types of integers, characters, or variables that are going to be scanned to the system, to the CPU. So here I'm going to take an, apart from this, I'm going to take an a character. So here I'm going to use an a four characters and then four integers values, where the A is a character which is of an array of size of 20, and FS is a character which is of a size of 50, and T is a character which is of an array of 6, and R is an array of 5. So in this, before that, initially I'm going to take the FS. Initially I'm going to take the FS which is of a 50 size of array with an empty cell. And apart from this, next, what is the next thing? I need to enter the data. That means the system has to give an information, or it has to display the data to give an information. So to read that information, I use a printf statement which says that enter the bit string. So whatever the bit string that has been entered from the keyboard, it has to be scanned. So we use a keyword called as an scanf, so which is taken as an percentage f by the processor, and those values will be get stored in an A only. Next question, why we have taken the array size is 20 itself? Why not other? So that is left to the user defined. You can take any number. So, but to my program, 20 is more than sufficient for me. That's why I'm going to take an array size of an 820. So whatever the bit string that I'm that is the sequence of data that I'm going to be entered will be stored in an A. So here the process is quite different what we have been seen. Actually, because the things will be quite different while writing in program. First, I am going to add an a header. Here, header is nothing but a 8 bit pattern of an 0, 111, 0. So this has to be first taken into a consideration. So to do that, what I am going to do, I am going to concatenate the string by using a command called strcat. That is a string concatenation. That means we are adding an a two strings. Here, which are those two strings? One is an a flag and another is an a empty. Why you have taken an empty? Because next I am going to take an a length of the string to an consideration, and we'll look for that. Fine. Next, once we have done the string concatenation, this will be concatenated with the FS, where the FS has gotten a empty cell, and the bit pattern will get concatenated and the stores a value. That is then FS is equal to 0, 111, 0. That means this is the source and this is the destination. Whatever the operation that is performed will be stored in the source itself. Next comes with an I need to, as I said that in a previous slide, measure of the length of an entered sequence. I need to measure what is the length of the sequence the user has been entered. So to do that, I've gotten one more function in an string.h file, which is called as an string length, which is generated by strlen. So this string length we of a, that means the a value what have been used in an string, that will be considered. So that is we compared with an number of that is how many number of string length I am going to be considered. For an example, if I consider the string length is equal to 3 3 is less than 5, yes, obvious, it is a statement is true. So to check the if condition, so here the if statement has a two condition. One, it will be can be a false, another it can be execute a true statement. So when the condition whatever have been given, if the condition is true, then it executes the true condition, or else it executes the false condition. So here I'm going to consider if string length is less than 5. That means if I say that the length of the string is 3, then 3 is less than 5. Is the statement is true? If it is true, it start concatenate the a value. That is 3. So how many bit? It's 3 bit, 1, 1, 1. It can gets concatenated with the 0, 111, 111, 0. So if the string length is more than 5, because the stuffing is what? The stuffing is a process. When I found a consecutive number of ones have been found, it has to be added a 0, right? So to do that, the true condition will be applicable till the 4 is less than 5. In case, if the enter of the string, the length of the string is more than 5 or 5 and more than 5, what the thing has to be done is the next question. So to do that, I've gotten a few more operation that I'm going to be included in my program. What is those? I use a for loop condition. This for loop condition is nothing but it acts like a counter. So if I take a counter, first, what is the first thing I need to do in a counter? First, in a counter, I need to initialize the values. Once the initialization is done, I need to give the counts. Once the count has been done, it has to increment the counter for a next value to be checked. In a similar pattern, the for condition is going to be executed. That is a loop function, loop execution, which is similarly to a count. We'll take an example. We'll take a condition. If I have initially the I is equal to 0, that means the counter is equal to 0. And check, 0 is less than the string length minus 4. Next question you can be arise, why I have taken minus 4, why not minus 5 or minus 6? Because I am going to check a string. For an example, if I say the length of the string is 5, then it will reaches this loop. So 5 minus 1 is how much? Is 1. So 0 is less than 1, yes. So if the condition is true, because this string length of a minus 4 is only to consider only a 3 or 4 sequence of numbers, and it increments the value of I. That means the first bit over, next it increments, the second bit over, it increments, the third bits over. And next, those values are taken into one more variable, or I can say that an integer, which is called as j. The same thing, when j is equal to I, that is indicate the j is equal to 0. So j is 0 plus 5. Yes, the condition is true. And when the condition is true, it start executing the inner loop, which is called tp plus plus is equal to a of j. Here the j value right now it's 0. That means a of j is 0. A of j is nothing but the first bit or first value of an A20 array size, and that will be included, or that will be added to then TP plus plus. Why TP plus plus? Means already the P has gotten 0 value, so I need to add this T value into a next bit of an array size. Hence we use T of 1 is equal to 0. So right now the T of 1 is what? Is 0. So if the T of 1 is 0, means what should be the T of 0? Next question. So to do that, I'm going to use a null function, which is indicated by T of P is equal to slash black slash of 0. When I use a black slash of 0, which indicates is a null function, where the TP of array will be assigned with a value called a 0. So now, right now, I need to compare this value. So T is often a 6 array, is it? Right now the value is what? 0, 1, double 0, 0, is it? 0, 1, double 0, 0, which is often 5. So now we need to compare those values then equal to 0 or not. If the value is 0 equals to 0, then I need to concatenate the things. That means adding an extra zeros all after the consecutive ones. So how this string comparison is going to be work, or how it functions in my program? The string comparison has an as we say that the comparison will have an a three condition. One, it can be an a greater, one it can be an a lesser, or another reason it can be an equal. So whenever the value, whatever the T array has got, right now the T array has got 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 5 bit, is it? So it will compare each and every bit with one another. So when I consider 0 and 1, here the first bit itself is an if fails, is it? So we going to consider this condition fails. Once this condition is fails, it again recollects a one more character which is called as an R of A. That is a 1 bit will be assigned to an R of 0, and those value get concatenated with a string operation that is called as an a string concatenation, and the values remains. Suppose if the values get compared or it's an equals to 0, what it has to do? It has to concatenate the values, that is n 111110, with the fs value. That is, the fs is nothing but already I have gotten a 8 bit pattern, it's get concatenated, and after getting concatenated I need to leave out those values and I need to go for a next sequence or a next bit of a data. So to go for a next sequence of a data, I have an a one more which is called as an I is equal to j of minus 1. So j of minus 1. So once it has been done, again the loop execution has been executed. Next it will go into initialize for a next sequence of a data to be considered. So once the data has been considered, the next sequence of a data will be taken into consideration by a variable or integer called as an q. So once it has been taken q, again the q will check whether the length of the string is more than whatever the string length have been entered. If the string length is greater, then it will execute the loop function. If not greater, then it starts concatenated things, and finally after stuffing we'll get an output. So we'll show the output of this. That is, we'll take a two condition. One condition is for a number of ones is greater than 5, means what will happen, and number of ones less than ones, that is number of ones is less than 5, means what will happen. The first case you can see, so as a user says enter the bit string, so user will enter the a number of ones which is more than 5 or equal to 5. So here I am going to enter 8 number of ones continuously. So in a stuffing, what I need to do, after every consecutive number of ones, extra 0 has to be added. So after execution of this all the program, what I have been explained, after in a final result, this is the first fs what it has been encatenated, and this is the process where the string length has been counted, and if the count is more than number of ones is 5, it will concatenate. If not it doesn't concatenate. So here in the given example, in a case 1, it has got a more than number of ones. So more than number of ones means it has to add an extra zeros. This extra zeros, once it has been added, once again it has to go for a next sequence of data, and it will check, that is j n is equal to I minus 1, that is this one. It will check whether this sequence will be taken from the q value, and those will be again compared. One again, if it is a consecutive number of ones is found, again the stuffing is going to be added. Once it has been added, next last finally what I need to do, I need to add the end flag. So to add this end flag, what are the things I need to do? All this together has to be concatenated with the final bit pattern. So this is the one case. And second case will go for when the number of ones is less than 5. So I am going to enter the bit string which is only a 3 in number. So when I consider this 3 in number, when the counter start, 3 is less than 5. So there is no need of doing those things. There is no need of doing a counting of a number of ones is how much, because the data enter itself is a number of 3 which is very less than 5. So we start concatenating the things. First what we concatenate, first we concatenate the starting frame, that is what is called as a starting delimiter, and a data, and an ending delimiter. So this is the overall program, how we are going to write a program to stuff the data whenever we find number of ones, the process of what we call as a bit stuffing. Next comes with a character stuffing. So this character stuffing will be explained after showing the demo of the how the stuffing is done. Good morning. So in the last session we have seen the bit stuffing program explanation and how to do that. Today we am going to show the video of how to run the simulations in an Ubuntu. So foremost, I've already created the folder called USN. So inside an USN, I've got an part B. So I'm going to create a file called as an bit.c. So we'll see or look how to create a file, execution file. So to do that, so right click on the desktop, select a new document. In a document, select an empty document. So in an empty document, give the name as your file name, which is optional. So but the extension should be .c, because the language what I'm going to write is a C programming language. So the C programming language it will be an a .c format. So in this .c format, so open the document, and already I have copied the file. I'll just paste it that, and I will see, I will give the explanation of it. So the character is a the character is a keyword where I'm going to say that these are the variables of a character keyword, and here the length of the string. Once the length of the string is less than this, it will get concatenated, string concatenation. If not, it will check for the number of ones to be executed, and this loop is check the number of ones. Once the number of ones is 5, is equal to 5, then it concatenates the 5 ones followed by 0. If not, then again it go back to the data, and it will assign with that, and it will act. If the all the thing is over the count of an sequence of the bit, next later on we'll have a delimiter, which is an ending delimiter or an end flag, and we'll obtain, finally obtain an output. So after doing that, just go to a file and save it. So control S or go to a file and give us a file and save the stuff. So once we have been saved, close this window, that is an editor window, and in a right click on the desktop. So select an open terminal, or else here we have already got an icon called as an a terminal. Open that. So right now the open terminal is an path called atme-virtualbox. So just navigate into an a desktop. So when we navigate into an a desktop, so to see what are the content available in a desktop, we have a command called ls, that is list of files or folders. So say enter. So in a desktop, I have gotten the blue color indicates the folders, and the white color files indicates the file, and a green color that is indicates then a jar files or a executable files. So right now this path shows that I'm in a desktop. So in a desktop, I've already created a file called bit.c, which has been created right now. So I need to compile. So to do that compile, I've gotten a GCC compiler. So is a command to run the GCC compiler is GCC space bit.c. If any errors occurs, you'll get a message. If not, the compile is done. Once the compile is done, the output has been to be done. This can be done in two ways, that is gcc bit dot c and run output file, or else directly give gcc file name space -o file name. That means -o means output. So right now defaultly the output will be stored in an a.v. to see the output or to execute this file, that is the dot out is an executable file. So to run that, I have got an instruction that dot slash a dot out. So when I give this command, it will ask for the enter the bit string. So as I said that I have gotten a two cases. Those two cases are which one? These two cases are this one, number of ones after there is number of ones, the number of ones is greater than 5 and number of ones is less than 5. So we'll look over to that. So what is that number of ones and number of zeros? So in this number of ones, so first we'll case for a first case. So I will follow by the, this is the length of the string what I have been given. So here the length of the string is given as an 8. That means what? After an 5 bits consecutive ones bit occurs, it has to be stuffed the 0, is it? So, and later on it has to consider the next sequence of a length. For an example, this is the one case. So, after doing that, enter the bit string, have entered. So, after stuffing, you can observe that. So, this stuffing where I not entered, but still, because in my program, you can look over to the program. So this is the starting, that is 0, triple one, 0. This get concatenated here, that is the starting delimiter, and this is the data, and this is the ending delimiter. So in a data you can observe that after a consecutive ones, number of ones occurs, the 0 has been appended. So in case we will take another example, that is the another case. Suppose if I write the give the string as 4 ones and 0, again 4 ones. And 0 again followed by number of ones. I don't know what is the count of that. We'll see whether it's get stuffed. So where I need to get stuff, here the 4 ones, stuff does not to be occurred. Here the 4 ones, so again stuff is not needed because the fifth character is in 1. Next again it starts from here. So when I count from here, after a 4, again it is a 1. So total it is in 5. So one more 0 has to be added. And again from here if I count 3, 4, 5, another 0 has to be. That means to this data, 2 zeros has to be append. So when I give the enter, in a program I have written a code to append that. You can look over. This is an what? This is the starting delimiter and this is the ending delimiter, and we'll check this. So this is the 4 ones, 0, which is similar to the data what I have been entered. Again the 4 ones, it's 0. So if the loop fails, again the data will enter, and here it will check whether till here it has been. Again it went for a next sequence, it is a consecutive 5 ones. Whenever I find a consecutive 5 ones, I need to add an a 0. So you can see the differentiate of this. So again after again consecutive ones, number of ones is 5, again 0 is going to be appended. So this process what we call as an a bit stuffing. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubts, please you can ping us, or you can reach us by pinging an email to then atmiaelectrons@gmail.com, and please get subscribed to our channel, that is Atmia Electrocrats, for your more videos on an computer networks lab. Thank you.